Good day, viewers and listeners. Welcome once again to Salida Teleradio of the La Filipina National High School. I am your teacher host, Sir Bernabe Sinabre, and today you will learn many things about graphs. Lesson in Mathematics 7, Quarter 4, Module 4. Are you all ready? Let's give the floor to teacher broadcaster, Sir Ariel Gratel.
Thank you, Sir Bernabe Sinabre. Once again, good day, everyone. To our students, viewers, and listeners, I am your teacher broadcaster, Sir Ariel Gratela. Today, we learn another topic in Grade 7 Mathematics, Quarter 4, Module 4. Our topic for today are all about graphs. We have three objectives to discuss. Our objectives are: first, define a graph. Second, describe a graph to represent an organized or gathered data. And third, select an appropriate graph to represent an organized or gathered data. But before we go further to our topic for today about graph, I will refresh your mind of ideas about this. I will give an activity and get a ball pen and a piece of paper to answer the activity. The allotted time is only 20 seconds. Okay, let us try this activity. So the direction is, you have to match each item in column A to its definition in column B. Write the letter only. I will now read to you the activity. Column A, number 1, pie chart. Column B, letter A, sometimes called a cumulative line graph, a type of frequency polygon that shows cumulative frequencies. Column A, number 2, bar graph. Column B, letter B, line chart. Column A, number 3, histogram. Column B, letter C, a diagram consisting of rectangles. Column A, number 4, line graph. Column B, letter D, the bars in a graph may be drawn horizontally or vertically. And lastly, for column A, number 5, ogive. For column B, letter E, also called as circle graph, a circle that is divided into sectors proportional to the frequencies. You only have 20 seconds to answer it, and your time starts now. Okay, let us answer now the activity. So here are the answers. For number 1, pie chart, the correct answer is letter E. For number 2, bar graph, the correct answer is letter D. For number 3, histogram, the correct answer is letter C. Number 4, line graph, the correct answer is letter B. And lastly, number 5, the ogive, the correct answer is letter A. I hope that you answer the activity correctly. Okay, let us now proceed to the definition of the graph. I will now read to you its definition. A graph is a diagram such as series of one or more points, lines, line segments, curves, or areas that represents the variation of a variable in comparison with that of one or more other variables. Let us proceed further. We have 5 different types of graphs and their description and corresponding illustration. Let us now proceed to the first type of graph. First, we have the pie chart or a circle graph. It is a circle that is divided into sectors proportion to the frequencies, and it shows how a part of something relates to the whole. So we have here an example. 800 commuters of Tagum City are distributed according to the type of transportation they use in a daily basis. So we have now the illustration of the pie chart. So it was being divided into four parts. So one mode of transport is we have the walking. 120 out of 800 commuters, or 15%. Second is we have the car. 80 out of 800 commuters, or comprising only of 10%. The third sector is we have the bus. 240 out of 800, or only 30%. And lastly, the biggest part or sector is we have the bicycle. 360 out of 800 commuters, so comprising of only 45% of the whole. Let us now proceed to the second type of a bar graph. So its definition is, it is used for making direct visual comparison of data. It shows the data collected during a survey or an observation. The bars in the graph may be drawn horizontally or vertically to represent the information. So we have here two illustrations of the bar graph. The first illustration and its example is, example, we have 60 students are asked to choose their favorite fruits. So the first illustration, or illustration A, it is a horizontal bar graph. The vertical axis of the graph shows the fruits chosen by the students. So we have here the following fruits: the orange, mango, pineapple, grapes, banana, and apple. For the horizontal axis of the graph shows the number of students that pick the fruits as their favorite. So the number of students are the following. We have 0, 5, 10, 15, and 20. And you can see the example and illustration, the number of students wherein they choose their favorite fruits. Okay, illustration B, as an example of a bar graph, the vertical bar graph. So we have here the pet owners for different animals. The vertical axis of the graph shows the number of different types of animals chosen by pet owners. So we have here the number of pet owners: 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. And the horizontal axis of the graph shows the different types of animals. So the following animals are cat, dog, rabbit, snake, fish, and hamster. So you can see now the illustration of the vertical bar graph. Okay, let us now proceed to the third type of the graph. We have the histogram. Its definition is a diagram consisting of rectangles whose area is proportional to the frequency of a variable whose width is equal to the class interval. So we have here an illustration and an example of this kind of graph. So math test scores of the 24 students. The vertical axis of the graph shows the frequency count. So the frequency count are numbers We have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. And the horizontal axis of the graph shows the scores of math test of 24 students. So the following scores are 5 to 8, 8 to 11, 11 to 14, 14 to 17. So you can see now in the illustration the frequency count with its corresponding scores. Let us now proceed to next type of the graph, the line graph or a line chart. It shows trends and data clearly. This displays data without queue, collected over a period of time to show how the data changes at regular intervals. So we have here an illustration, an example of this kind of graph. So number of confirmed cases, that is COVID-19, from January 31 to February 6. The vertical axis of the graph shows the number of confirmed cases from January 31 to February 6. So the numbers are, we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the horizontal axis of the graph shows the data for 7 days of confirmed cases. So we have the following dates are January 31, February 1, February 2, February 3, February 4, February 5, and February 6. It shows now the trend of the line as given in the example. And lastly, the fifth type of the graph is we have the ogive. Its definition is sometimes called a cumulative line graph. It is a type of frequency polygon that shows cumulative frequencies. In other words, the cumulative percents or percent are added on the graph from left to right. So we have here an illustration, an example of the ogive. The vertical axis of the graph shows the cumulative frequencies. It is being represented by numbers from 0, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, to 140. And the horizontal axis of the graph shows the boundaries in percent. So the following percents are, we have 0.5%, 5.5%, 10.5%, 15.5%, 20.5%, and 25.5%. As you can see in the given example, the lines of the given graph. Okay, since you have already a clear idea about the graph, I would like you again to get a piece of paper and ball pen and answer this activity. This is a multiple choice activity and the direction is you only have to choose the letter of your correct answer. And then the allotted time of this activity for each number is only 5 seconds. And I will now read to you the activity with its corresponding answer. So, here is the first number. Number 1, a circle. Graph is a circle divided into sectors proportioned to the frequencies. It shows how a part of something relates to the whole. I repeat, a circle graph is a circle divided into sectors proportioned to the frequencies. It shows how a part of something relates to the whole. The choices are letter A, pie chart, letter B, bar graph, letter C, histogram, letter D, line graph. I repeat, letter A, pie chart, letter B, bar graph, letter C, histogram, and letter D, line graph. You have 5 seconds and your time starts now. Time's up. The correct answer is letter A, pie chart. Let us now proceed to number 2. It is a graph used for making direct visual comparison of the data. The bars in the graph may be drawn horizontally or vertically to represent information. Okay, I will read again. It is a graph used for making direct visual comparison of the data. The bars in the graph may be drawn horizontally or vertically to represent information. So we have here the choices. Letter A, pie chart. Letter B, histogram. Letter C, bar graph. And letter D, line graph. So I will read it again. Letter A, pie chart. Letter B, histogram. Letter C, bar graph. And letter D, line graph. You have 5 seconds to answer it. Your time starts now. Time's up. And the correct answer is letter C, bar graph. Let us proceed now to number 3. A diagram consisting of rectangles whose area is proportional to the frequency of variable and whose weight is equal to the class interval. So I will read it again. It is a diagram consisting of rectangles whose area is proportional to the frequency of variable and whose weight is equal to the class interval. And we have the report choices. For letter A, a pie chart. Letter B, histogram. Letter C, bar graph. And letter D, line graph. Again, letter A, pie chart. Letter B, histogram. Letter C, bar graph. And letter D, line graph. So for 5 seconds, your time starts now. Time's up, and the correct answer is letter B, histogram. Okay, let us proceed to number 4. A line chart shows trends in data clearly. This displays data which are collected over a period of time to show how the data changes at regular interval. I repeat, it is a line chart shows trend and data clearly. This displays data which are collected over a period of time to show how the data changes at regular interval. So we have here the 4 choices. For letter A, bar graph. Letter B, histogram. Letter C, the ogive. And letter D, line graph. So I will read it again. Letter A, bar graph. B, histogram. C, ogive. And D, line graph. For 5 seconds, answer it and your time starts now. Time's up. And the correct answer is line graph. And lastly, number 5. It is also called a cumulative line graph, a type of frequency polygon that uses cumulative frequencies. The cumulative percent are added on the graph from left to right. So I will read it again. It is also called a cumulative line graph, a type of frequency polygon that shows cumulative frequencies. The cumulative percent are added on the graph from left to right. So the choices are letter A, bar graph, letter B, histogram, letter C, ogive, and letter D, line graph. So I repeat, letter A, bar graph, letter B, histogram, letter C, ogive, and letter D, line graph. For 5 seconds, your time starts now. Time is up. And the correct answer is ogive. I hope that you have answered the activity correctly. And for those who got the perfect score, congratulations. For those who did not, better luck next time. And for your assignment is to watch or listen the next episode of Salida Teleradio of La Filipina National High School. I hope our students, viewers, and listeners have learned something today in our lesson about graphs. Thank you so much and see you next time. Bye-bye.
That was great. Thank you, Sir Ariel, and thank you, listeners and viewers, for tuning in. I hope you have learned something today. Once again, this is your teacher host, Sir Bernabe Senabre, saying, if math is hard and so is life, then get over it. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.